We're just going to get started. I'm going to introduce the first two numbers and we'll just kind of take a turn on the programs. It says meet whoever else. So I'm Catherine, and it just says little blurbs on us in the program. But our first number is by the Italian composer Ennio Morricone. And he was a conductor, an orchestra, a trumpeter, and a pianist. As a young man in the 40s, he played the trumpet in jazz bands. A few years later, he became a studio arranger, and a few years after that, Morricone started ghostwriting for films and theater, and that's how he got his start. He is considered one of the most prolific and greatest film composers of all time. Just 4 years ago, he passed away at the age of 91 in Italy, and this world has been truly blessed by his talents and gifts. Our first piece, Gabriel's Oboe, is one that many of you will recognize. It's the main theme for The Mission, is the name of the movie from 1986. It's been called both lyrical and stately. As you listen, I want each of you to think of what memories it might recall or how it makes you feel. Enjoy.
Thank you.
I'm so grateful that you're here. Anybody, show of hands, did you recognize it? Did you guys know that? Yes. Such a neat piece. Okay, on to the next one. Piece number two. Astor Piazzolla was an Argentine composer and arranger that played an instrument that you may have never heard of before, unless you're a tango ensemble expert. Anyone here? Tango ensemble? It's an accordion-like instrument popular in Argentina, tango groups, and it's called a bandoneon. Next time you hear an accordion playing a tango piece, it may not actually be an accordion. It could be a bandoneon. And for any of those of you that are in the room that have a hobby of collecting instruments, you're welcome. You may have just discovered what to get yourself for your next birthday. In our next piece, listen for the special rhythm played by the cello. If you play it fast, you can recognize it in popular Spanish music known as reggaeton. Bom, ba-dum, bom, bom. It's that kind of a beat, but this has it very slow and came way before reggaeton. It's called a milonga rhythm, and it's actually the Argentine precursor to tango. So enjoy. This piece is called Oblivion by Piazzolla. Thank you. the same string quartet. It's by Borodin. He was a Russian composer in the 19th century, but he wasn't just a composer. In fact, his day job and what he considered to be his primary career was as a scientist. He was a chemist and a doctor, and he kind of considered that his main thing, and you still may find his name in science textbooks today because he was pretty instrumental in the kind of early stages of organic chemistry, and especially for something that's now called the Borodin reaction. That said, he's now more famous as a composer. He's grouped with five composers from Russia that are called the Russian Five. They were doing big things for classical music in Russia in the late 1800s. I kind of wish that Borodin had more time to compose classical music because I love his music, it's very beautiful. This particular string quartet is one of his most famous, and he wrote it in dedication to his wife for their 20th anniversary. So as you listen, you'll probably notice that it sounds very much like a love song. This whole quartet, both of the movements that we'll play now, have a lot of beautiful lyrical melodies that pass back and forth between the cello and violin. So just sit back and think of the people that you love and enjoy this beautiful music by Borodin.
Thank you. Stories by night. So this next piece is Adagio by Albinoni. So there's a little bit of musical controversy here because Albinoni was a Baroque composer, so hundreds of years ago, but Remo Giazzotto was an Italian composer much more recently, within the last 100 years, and he claimed that he got this, well, he wrote this, and then he said, well, I got it from this Baroque composer, Albinoni. And then he said that he had a manuscript that he used to write this piece. And then the library that that piece was in conveniently burned down. And then later he said, well, no, actually that was all me. I didn't use any of that guy's music. So a little bit of musical controversy there. So it's Adagio by Albinoni, but it's really by Giazzotto. So it's gonna have a little bit of Baroque, so much older, but it's gonna also kind of sound a little bit more recent, more romantic. This is another one that you may recognize that you'll find in different movies, and it's become very popular. So this is Adagio.
Thank you.
Catherine already graced us with a lot about Piazzolla. So now we get another tango from Piazzolla. This one's a little more upbeat. Okay? So see if you can hear that rhythm. I'll play it for you. It goes like this. Okay? So if you listen for that rhythm, it's going to go throughout the whole piece. Okay?
Thank you.
if you're wondering, they switch because that's where the first violin normally sits. So they're switching because they're switching who's playing first violin and who's playing second violin. Because they're both so talented. They both do. Thank you.
Thank you.